Okay, you have played with almost every cricketer, means from Maharashtra also and from Kerala also. Now in this round, you have to give means one good. You have to say one good qualities and one bad qualities about a player. Okay, first is Ankur Singh. What is the good quality of Ankur Singh? What is the bad quality of Ankur Singh?
Ankur Singh's good quality, I said captaincy, confidence, bowling, knowing about the game, presence of mind. And you know, every character is just about a game. It's an amazing quality. And bad quality, I don't have any bad quality, but he is batting really well also. But sometimes he's like overconfident about his batting. Mm-hmm. So that is the thing.
Okay. And what about Krishna Satpute?
Krishna Satpute, good quality, he watches every ball. See, he used to travel a lot, he travel all India, he used to travel GCC countries. So, we might be thinking, okay, he don't know this bowler, so let him bowl against Krishna. But if Krishna had faced him before, he'll be sure, he might have noticed him really well, okay. So, any variations he might have noticed really well, he will be remembering him. He's not like simply facing one time and next time forgetting and not like that. He remembers every bowlers, every variations, and that's a very good quality. That's why he is the number one batsman. He used to travel anywhere, he used to go and he performs really well. This is the country, Kerala, India, anywhere in India, he performs really well. So that's a great quality. And because even at this age also, he's performing really well.
Exactly.
And bad quality, I don't know much, but I heard about like, he used to like, you know, tell, okay, it's one team, and you know, commit to one team and play for other team.
Okay.
So, it's not, that is the only thing I heard bad about Krishna bhai. That is, you have to be little, you know, fair in this. You know, you can't do like, commit to one team and okay, the next team offers you more money, okay, I'll pay in that team. It shouldn't be like that. If you commit, you should play for that team only.
A very good answer you have given to us, means one of the best controversial statement I can say. And I'll just probe this and put it on my story. I just want to see what Krishna transmitted to
Once I heard, okay, a couple of years back or last year, I think, in Tenpil, I think they had banned him for a match or for the whole tournament, something had happened. So, the reason was that he had committed to a team and some other team had offered him a lot extra money.
Okay.
So, he went for the other team. So, they go to the committee, the organizers came to know that and they said, this is the highest, toughest tournament in the world, I mean tennis world cricket. So, we don't want anything happening in our tournament like this. We are giving more pride to the commitments, to the values, to the promises we are giving as a player. Not, you don't want any player going behind.
You want to say that Krishna Satpute plays for money, right? All in all, you want to say that?
No, not like that. Not like that. He is a professional player. See, he is spending a lot of, every day he is spending like, I think, a lot of time for his practice, everything. He is living with his money he is earning from tennis ball cricket. So, this is his job. He can wait. You shouldn't be doing commit to a team. Committing means it's agreed, it's a promise. Before committing, okay, if they are offering this much money, he could tell like, okay, wait, I'll just think about it. And if he's putting promise with the other team, means with who are giving extra money, means okay, no problem. But after giving a commitment, okay, whatever the money you are giving, I'll be playing in your team. Okay, after giving that promise and changing while the tournament day comes, that's not good, I see. That's not good.
So, like you said that after committing, means Krishna is not playing in that team. So, what is the reason behind that, means according to you? Means like some other team is paying more?
There can be two reasons. One is more money. The other thing is maybe someone of his friend or someone who he knows well will be from the other team. Who is giving him the chance.
Good relation with that person, like that, something like that.
Relationship or something like that. But even his good friend or extra money, whatever they promise, you shouldn't be breaking the promise you have given to a team.
As a captain,
I used to, you know, in Kerala, Victoria comes, I used to think a lot of players I need to put up and to make up a team is very difficult, okay, very, very difficult. For a good tournament, we need to make up a team like 2-3 months before only. So after getting from a promise from a player, and like after 2-3 weeks, if he's telling or he's playing for other team, it's very difficult to find another player for in his place. So it's very difficult for the players. Yeah.
So for the team and owner to prepare all the things.
Yeah, if it's normal local tournament, it's okay. But for big prestigious tournament, you know, if only eight players in a team, we'll be thinking a lot about these eight players. Okay, so after getting a commitment and changing at the last moment is very difficult.
But you have given a very solid controversial statement here.